Hello guys, Brad here again with another fragrance review. I've gotten a fragrance set from Velk. It's just a bunch of fragrances, samples. Eight fragrances. Two of these I've tried already, the John Varvatos Original and Eternity for Men from Calvin Klein. But the other six I haven't tried before, so I thought I'd go ahead and try this one here, Bad Boy from Caroline Herrera. And on the back, there's a little bit of the description here. Bad Boy is a fragrant expression of duality, representing the bold nature of the modern man. At once strong and sensitive, confident and relaxed, the Bad Boy embraces his contrasting characteristics with assured ease. Bad Boy Eau de Toilette is a fragrance of layered notes, inspired by the Bad Boy's complexity and harmoniously combined for a distinctive blend of modern sophistication. So this one came out in 2019, Amber Spicy classification with black pepper, white pepper and bergamot in the top, middle notes of sage and cedar in the mid, base of tonka bean, cacao, and amberwood in the base. So, I'm going to say right off the bat, I'm not overly impressed with this one. For one thing, it doesn't really have a Bad Boy aspect to it. When I think Bad Boy, I'm going to think, if it was up to me, I would start with a black leather Accord, like a black leather biker jacket, mix that with some tobacco, maybe some whiskey, some animalic herbs and spices, maybe some woods. That to me would be a Bad Boy fragrance. This to me, well, I get mostly tonka bean and cedar wood here. This kind of smells like a ripoff of Armani Code to my nose. So I'm really not that impressed with it. There is a cacao note in here. Some people say they get a chocolatey aspect. To me, it's not really all that chocolatey. You might get a powdery chocolate-like nuance in the base that just kind of blends with the tonka bean a little bit to give it a slight difference, but mostly it's about tonka bean and cedar to my nose. So I'm not overly impressed here, and it's not really that cheap either, so I would say, you know, it's pretty much a pass for me. I think the bottle's pretty interesting. See the bottle there? It's like a lightning bolt or something. I'm not sure exactly what that is, but yeah, the bottle is interesting, but that's mostly the most exciting thing for me as far as this fragrance goes. Some people say they like this fragrance, and if that's the case, more power to you, but for me, it just did not strike me as anything too exciting or unique. Smell, I'll give it 6.5 out of 10. I thought it smelled all right. I like Armani Code. I do like tonka bean fragrances, but they have been done to death. Unless you can come up with something a little bit different and unique, I'm not going to be impressed. Projection longevity, 4 to 6 hours, so we'll give it about 7.5 out of 10. Versatility, more for cool spring, fall, winter time, more so than summer. You could probably wear this one more for like evening wear, date night. You could probably wear it to work as well if you lighten up on the sprays. It's just like basically just your standard tonka bean as far as I'm concerned. So versatility, 7 out of 10. Uniqueness, 5 out of 10. The cacao didn't really strike me as anything too different here from other tonka bean fragrances. It didn't really come out and strike me as like a chocolatey nuance. It just kind of barely smelled it. Price point fragrance net, 3.4 ounces, $81.89, with an overall score for me, 6 out of 10, mostly because it's been done to death. The tonka bean woods type smell, the cacao just didn't really heighten the experience at all for me. So that's my thoughts on Carolina Herrera's Bad Boy, my first of several samples to check out with this Velk fragrance kit. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you guys later.